Before I get started in the subject of today's video, I want to speak about an omission that I had in yesterday's video and error I had and the day before that. It sometimes happens, and the format I have to do these videos now on account of you stealing from our maker. Don't have access to computer or regular internet service, so I have to use the phone, and I have limited amount of notes. And like my predecessor Moses that gateway drew out from the waters of Egypt, I'm a poor speaker stutter. I have a bad, as far as the world goes, very poor speaker. I lose my train of thought and I get so much on my mind, jumbling details around in these videos especially. Get just things come into my mind, bombarding me when I do them too. And anyway, excuses, but I'm a poor speaker, and that reflects itself in these videos. But for instance, to give you an example, in the omission that I had in yesterday's video, I was talking about the 513 days prior to this F17 waypoint being the beginning of the all wine between 10 of days, which was 504, his first day of those waypoints. And I pointed out that 513 was his first messenger of blood delivery waypoint for the Emmanuel Manchild Meher Shalal Kushbaz. But I omitted the punchline. I omitted the best thing about it, and that is 513 was that not only the first delivery messenger waypoint, it was the 10th day of his Nehemiah 518 all wine between 10 a days prophecy. Phenomenal detail to omit. Anyway, in the video before that, I spoke about some of the maternity clothes being delivered at 3:04 p.m. Stupid bonehead mistakes. I mean, 3:04 is a big waypoint too in his Meher Shalal Kushbaz way timeline, but for different reasons. But delivered at 3:06, and I spoke about how it paralleled 3:04 paralleled the Numbers Don't Lie video. What was 3:06 that I talked about in that Numbers Don't Lie video? So I had the parallel correct. I just spoke it wrong. So they're delivered at 3:06 p.m. that day, which has huge significance too. And with the day number 3:06 is 11:06, our Maker's Restored Calendar, which that was the day that he caused at the end of that day, caused the Emmanuel Manchild Meher Shalal Kushbaz and his twin sister Rachel to be miscarried from the womb. Add on that, expand upon that here a little bit later in this video. Truly amazing. And anyway, well, 3:06 is just all sorts of things tie into 3:06 that I haven't even talked about in these videos, but the clothes were delivered at 3:06 p.m., not 3:04. And anyway, tying into the Numbers Don't Lie video, we talked about the significance of 3:06 and stuff, how that went in there. But anyway, that was a big omission and a big error that I made. Not so big, but I have others. Sometimes I correct them in the video description box of the video if I catch it early enough, or sometimes I mention them in the next video. Sometimes I think they're not that important, and you should have caught them anyway. If you're paying attention to the details, you'd say, wait a minute, he meant so-and-so, such-and-such a number. You know, because I yesterday's video too, I think I said 1212 one time. But I said it 1221 correctly the other times. You know, I make the mistakes like that. So anyway, you know, shoot me. I don't care. So anyway, on with today's video. There remains just 2 days, including today, before tomorrow night's 3 a.m. double Abraham Lights waypoint. I've been meditating quite a bit upon this F17 3 a.m. waypoint in relation to his dual spaces of his silence from his dual heavens, or the final 14 days of his Revelation chapter 8 silence from his dual heavens. When he ceases from short of the days. If this F17 vision waypoint does bring forth the end of his holding this back at 3 a.m. tomorrow night, these final 14 days of his silence from his dual heavens began at 3 a.m. during the night of the 23rd day of the 11th month. The significance of this is huge. Therefore, the first day of these 14 days was the 24th day of the 11th month of his Zechariah chapter 1, four spirits, four horns, four carpenters, man riding upon the red horse who's beneath the shade of the myrtle tree prophecy. For those of you who have not watched other videos, Yihweh does not reckon each day from midnight to midnight like his servant Satan taught some of his subjects to take and reckon the days. Nor does he reckon it from sunset to sunset like he taught others of his servants, the Danites, to reckon the days. He reckons them from sunrise to sunrise. Just just what it is. So 3 a.m. tomorrow night will be tomorrow night. In case you're thinking it might be tonight. Anyhow, the 24th day of the 11th month was not only the first day of his fourth messenger of blood that he sent forth 2 years earlier with the younger of the dual wives of his Zechariah chapter 5 prophecy. This day this year, the 24th day of the 11th month, was the first day of his third messenger of blood that he has sent to accompany the elder of these dual wives that are journeying forth upon the dual wings of a stork, lifting up his Meher Shalal Kushbaz Ephah between his dual heavens and the earth, as they build his house in Shinar, a.k.a. Mystery Babylon, per his Zechariah chapter 5 prophecy. Amazing. Fourth messenger of blood with the younger of these wives. Third messenger of blood 2 years later with the elder wife. What are the odds of this? This is amazing stuff. Totally amazing stuff. The 24th day of the 11th month is day number 324 of the year on the Most High's restored calendar, among much, much more. I'm pointing that out because 324 was his servant that he drew out from the waters of Egypt's seventh day on the mountain when he called out to his servant Moses, "Come on up to me," he said. But he was already up on the mountain. Come on up on the seventh day. Amazing. The seventh day of this elder wife's third messenger of blood that began on 11/24, but the seventh day was the last day of Yahweh's 6,000th year, 50th year, year of the ram's horn release of debts. What are the odds? All this stuff's amazing. You should have chosen to come to his house this past year to have your debts to him released. After all, his Zechariah chapter 5 prophecy tells us that the 20 cubit by 10 cubit, the 200 square cubit, oath of his curse, is being sent forth upon those of you who are stealing from him and submitting to his name falsely. You could have had that which you stole from him purged. But you didn't do it. You didn't take advantage of his offer. I'd call that a major, major mistake. Folks, this is real stuff. His silence from his dual heavens must one day come to an end. His word says so. There's no way to get around this reality. This reality that I believe is at hand right now. 3 14-day periods is 42 days, paralleling the three tiers of 14 generations that preceded his only begotten son, from Abraham to his only begotten son. Truly amazing stuff. 42 days prior to tomorrow's F17 waypoint was 10:25 on the Almighty's restored calendar. This waypoint fell on 12:7 on his servant Satan's calendar. Per his great Meher Shalal Kushbaz Mir of his Isaiah chapter 8 prophecy, 12:7 was the day that he caused his servant Abraham to raise the knife to offer up his only begotten son of his wife Sarah's womb. It's also the day that he caused his servant Moses that he drew out from the waters of Egypt to go sleep with his fathers. These are just realities. It was on this 10:25, 12:7 waypoint. Listen closely. It was on this 10:25, 12:7 waypoint that he caused the 88 square foot queen's tent to be reared up. That's amazing. This was the seventh day of his first messenger of blood that he sent forth with the elder wife. That's truly, truly amazing. He first caused her to first be conceived, him and his twin sister Rachel, in the womb. Therefore, the next day was the eighth day and the first day of the third conception of the Emmanuel man-child Meher Shalal Kushbaz and his twin sister Rachel. The first two conceptions were in the younger wife's womb a couple years earlier. Truly amazing. These two offspring of his Isaiah chapter 6 holy seed conceived on the following eighth day with his holy seed of the seventh day of this conception. The pattern that he sent forth. Except he broke it this next time when he put him back in the womb. Yahweh caused them to miscarry 4 days after this eighth day conception at the end of 11-6, 306, day number 306, before the dawning of 11-7. 11-7, 11-8, when the Spirit entered into me, way a point back then, several years ago and such. Truly amazing. 11-7 ended up being her, that was actually in the F-17 dream, if you think about it, but And different things there, but I tied in that. I'm not going to go back into the details with that. I want to talk about the details of this vision, but it's not important. But all of these details are beyond amazing in that which they testify to. It's you that have been miscarried. He's just afflicted me in your stead. It's your children that have been miscarried, and much, much more. They testify to so many things, the timing of the days. If we put these twins back into the womb of his revelation, chapter 12, wife that has fled into the wilderness upon the dual wings of a great eagle. He put the twins back in the womb 11 days later with his holy seed that he caused to go into his wife on the third day of the 7 days of conception. But the third day wasn't 7 days of conception at that time, because on the third day he showed me clearly that she had conceived. But on the third day that she was clean. And these children were conceived on the next day with the third day seed on the fourth day. The third day was the 10th day when he removed them. The third stroke. He said, there's not going to be a fourth stroke. For three and for four, he's going to smite you. Doesn't say for four and for five. These are just this is just realism. It's that the testimony of his word believes. Believe his word. Who has ever heard of this? He says in his Mahershal Kush Baz prophecy in Isaiah chapter 66. Who has seen these things in the first verse, he asks, in relation to him not closing these dual wives' wombs. Like I said, the details that he has woven into these things and what they testify to is beyond amazing. Folks, whether his silence comes from to an end tomorrow night at 3 a.m. or whether he does so in relation to his backup Passover memorial of the second month, doesn't really matter, does it? What's a month's time at this point? But all these details point that his silence from his dual heavens is coming to an end tomorrow night. It means that he's no longer going to afflict me in your stead. That means that straightway the sun and the moon are going to go dark. Don't you have any fear of the Almighty? Is there no belief of his word whatsoever in your rebellious, uncircumcised heart that you know better than everything? You want to gamble your children away on Saul of Tarsus' teachings, even though the testimony of Yahweh's word totally refutes it from one book, from the first word to the last word. His only begotten son clearly testified against Saul of Tarsus. Saul of Tarsus said, follow me on my more excellent way, which it was what he thought was a more excellent way. Yahweh Elohim told us in places like, these are the truths, chapter 13, aka the book of Deuteronomy, if any man, that includes Saul of Tarsus people, if any man comes to you with another pathway, stone him. Why don't you believe him?